Hi, Maria Watkins here from the Music Business Made Easy. Today we're going to look at music in the public domain. Any song, composition, or any creative work that is entered the public domain, that means it's free to use. It's no longer under intellectual property law. You can use any part of it, the music, the lyrics, the text, anything. You can use it to create new works, make remixes, new arrangements. And once you do that, you can copyright that. Here's the tricky part. Just like you can use that work in the public domain, so can anyone else. So when choosing to use a work in the public domain, make sure that it is in fact the actual original work and not someone else's new creation from the original work. Let me use this example. I'll just make up a title. Let's say the song Love Works is now in the public domain. Songwriter A comes along, writes a new arrangement of Love Works, copyrights that arrangement. It is now protected by copyright law. Songwriter B comes along, discovers that the song Love Works is in the public domain, but instead of working from the original work, they work from songwriter A's new copyrighted arrangement of the work in which they would need a license instead of the original work. This also applies to sheet music, so be sure to check all copyright information. How do we know if a song has entered the public domain? In the United States, any songs, words, and music that were published before January 1st, 1923, those songs are in the public domain. This means that the copyright protection and all of the exclusive rights that goes to each one of those songs have expired and now are available to anyone to use however they choose. Any work that was published before 1964 and those copyrights were not renewed, those works fell into the public domain. As far as renewals go, it's important to note that any work that was published before 1978, copyright renewals were required. So be sure to check first if any works were renewed that are candidates for public domain. Any work where the author releases a statement or lets it be known that they are releasing all of their rights to their music and wants to release it to the public, those works fall into the public domain. Another fact to be aware of is that works that were published in the United States before March 1, 1989, those published works required a copyright notice, and the works without that notice fell into the public domain. Any song that doesn't have a composer or is a folk song, those songs are also in the public domain. Be sure now that you understand I'm speaking of actual songs, the words, the melody, the music, not the recorded versions of songs or the sound recordings. As of this recording, 2019, there are no sound recordings in the United States that are free and available to the public to use without permission until 2067. Where can you go to start researching information about songs? You can start at the copyright.gov website and use their search function to look for copyright information, dates of published works, authors, and composers, or you can pay them to do some research for you. You can also pay any licensing company to do research for you to know whether or not a song is in the public domain, such as tunelicensing.com, easysonglicensing.com, or songfile.com. Some free search options include Wikipedia. By inserting the title of the song with the word song at the end, you can get some song results that way. You can go to the website cpdl.org, which stands for Choral Public Domain Library, or Choral Wiki, where you can search for free choral and vocal scores, texts, translations, and other useful information. And you can search the website pdinfo.com, the Public Domain Information Project, where they have a huge list of public domain music and songs that are available to use. If you're looking for great creative ideas, having writer's block, or just searching for something new to spark your own creativity, these resources are available to you freely and you don't need permission. If this information is helpful to you, indicate to me below that you understand that I'm speaking of the United States copyright law and that other countries have their own laws by which they are governed. So you take care now and have a great day.